How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today I'm going to show you guys a few ways you can change your IP address. And I also recommend the one best way to change your IP address, especially if you're seeking to unblock streaming services and bypass geo restrictions, or just simply if you're looking to secure your device. So now, a few ways to change your IP address is simply by contacting your internet service provider or ISP and asking them to simply change it for you. And maybe they'll oblige. And if they don't, what you could do is turn off your router for 5 to 10 minutes. You might have to turn it off, just leave it overnight, actually, sometimes, if it doesn't work. When you do turn off your router, you're pretty much letting go of your IP address so that your ISP could recycle that IP address and give it to somebody else. And once you turn on your router again, you'll be able to kind of get a new IP address, hopefully. If that doesn't work, another way is, of course, by using the Tor browser, because when you're using the Tor browser, you are using a host of IP addresses, actually. Everything is quite a bit scrambled within the Tor browser, but beware, your ISP will be able to tell that you're using the Tor browser using your real IP address, but they won't be able to tell what you're doing within the Tor browser because everything is encrypted. And again, it's scrambled by a whole bunch of IP addresses given the nature of the Tor browser. So that's one way to do it. Another way to change your IP address is by simply changing networks. You can use your mobile data or another Wi-Fi if it's available. And if you're on Windows, for example, you can go to CMD, all right, and just run as administrator, bring it over here, type ipconfig, all right, /release, and that will release your IP address, and then type ipconfig again, ipconfig. /renew. And this should, operation can't be performed. Yeah, that's pretty much it. So ipconfig /release and then ipconfig /renew. And really is as simple as that. This should change your IP address. But of course, if you're looking to change your IP address in order to bypass geo restrictions and streaming services and such, of course, you're going to have to use a VPN. That'll be the best way to change your IP address. If you don't want to use a VPN, you can definitely use a proxy extension. For whatever Chrome, be it Chrome or Firefox, whatever browser you're using, you can download a proxy extension and you'll be able to use these proxy servers and change your IP address. But your connection won't be encrypted because when using a VPN, of course, you're encrypting your traffic. Everything you're doing online will be encrypted and your ISP won't be able to know what you're doing. So if you're trying to change your IP address because you're in a censorship heavy country and you're trying to cover up your tracks, it is definitely advisable that you would use a VPN rather than just changing your IP address. Another reason to change your IP address using a VPN is, of course, as I mentioned earlier, is if you're trying to bypass geo restrictions, especially with regards to streaming services, because using proxies or any other way to change or to bypass geo restriction in order to reach streaming services, it's not going to happen. You're not going to be able to do that without using a VPN, because with VPNs, you'll be getting these optimized servers that'll give you access to streaming services without any hassle. And of course, using VPN is definitely the safer option if you're trying to cover up your tracks, especially if you're in a censorship-heavy country. Now, how do you change your IP address with a VPN? I do have a few recommendations here. NordVPN, Surfshark, and ExpressVPN. Of course, my recommended would be ExpressVPN if you're in a censorship-heavy country and if you're just looking for the best VPN for streaming services and obfuscation, especially if you're in a restrictive country, then ExpressVPN will definitely be the one to go for. It'll allow you to secure up to 5 devices, and it has 94 regions and up to 3,000 servers. And you've got NordVPN, which will allow you to secure up to 6 devices. It has over 5,200 servers in 60 countries, and Surfshark will allow you to secure an unlimited amount of devices and over 3,200 servers in 65 countries. So, you know, all these VPNs are some of the best VPNs in the industry, and you'll definitely be able to get what you're looking for out of these VPNs, no matter what you're looking for. And not to worry in terms of budgeting, because all these VPNs have various budgets, ExpressVPN being the most expensive because it is the most secure one and most reliable one, followed up by NordVPN and Surfshark being the cheapest, but it also has a very generous plan, allowing you to secure an unlimited amount of devices and still giving you plenty of features. So let's go over how you can change your IP address. Of course, you know, if you're an ExpressVPN, just go to VPN locations, pick one of these servers, whatever it is, whatever country you're looking for. I was earlier connected to the New York server, so it appears as if I'm in New York on whatismyipaddress.com. But let's say I want to use NordVPN now. Let's just connect to Poland, for example, and see what happens. And to make sure that you have changed your IP address, of course, you can just go to whatismyipaddress.com and refresh whatismyip-address.com. There are many other websites you can also check, but this is the website that I use. Of course, as you can tell, the IP address did change, and it really is as simple as that. It should show that I'm in Poland. So that's pretty much it. Again, if you guys are interested in learning more about these VPNs, by the way, be sure to check the links in the description down below. That'll give you more of an in-depth look into the privacy policy, speed, streaming, torrenting capabilities, and security and features of these VPNs. Keep in mind that all these VPNs do have a 30-day money-back guarantee. So whatever VPN, no matter which plan you choose of these VPNs, they're all covered by a 30-day money-back guarantee, so it's a risk-free process. You'll also find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below if you guys are interested. Besides that, thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a wonderful day.